Welcome to Ridge Life. I'm Tim, and today I have got a West Tennessee deer hunt for you. You're sure to enjoy. We've got doe walking to and fro. We've got fox. We've got a nice Tennessee buck harvested at the end. Make sure you stick around. I think you're going to enjoy the show. That was awesome. Well, that was exciting. Whoa. I just had a nice, nice buck cross the field here just after 7 o'clock. This weekend after Thanksgiving. And got a nice shoulder hit on it. You can tell the front right leg was immobilized. It went down, and then it got back up and went about 70 yards, I think. I think I heard it crash in the woods over there. We'll go check that in a minute. About 6 o'clock this morning, I had four deer come from the same direction, cross the field, and all I could just barely make out their body. I couldn't tell, I couldn't see enough to even, you know, focus my eyes, much less look through a scope. So they walked through, meandered across this field very, very slowly. Again, it was just too dark. But yeah, that buck came through. I didn't have a chance to get the GoPro going, but I did get the camcorder. I didn't get to zoom in on it, so you could see the antlers real big when I took the shot. But I do believe the shot is on the camera, so you get to see that. Audio won't be as good, but so it went down. I'm going to give it a few more moments. Since it did get back up, make sure it just wasn't a shoulder injury. Didn't get a vital. Yeah, you just, you know, looked like a good shot the way he reacted. I'll know better when I look closer at the video. But give it a little time. Wow, what a beautiful, beautiful day. It's not quite as cold today. Yesterday it was 25 degrees. Oh, so cold. But today it's right at freezing. And a beautiful day here in West Tennessee. The sky's mostly blue. A little bit overcast, sun's just coming up. If I can get this deer field dressed and hung, I can make it to church this morning. So let me go check this deer here in a minute, and I'll see y'all soon. We're at the point of impact, and if we look right over here, we can see our stand is right there on that tree, about 70 yards away. And if I look right here, you saw there was some fur right there. I can see where he went down right over here. You see all the tracks that are pushed over. Yeah, see, he knocked everything over right here. Now we need to see if we can find the blood where he fell. Look. All right, here's where he fell. You see he fell down right here. I don't see a lot of blood, though. Gotta be some... Oh, here we go. Here we go. Right here. Tons of blood right there. All right, now we just gotta follow this blood trail. Follow that blood trail all the way out. See, he's dragging his leg right here. See him dragging that leg? Now we just gotta follow this out. I heard him, pretty sure I heard him crash, you know, about 100 yards or so that way. Nice blood here, kind of frothy, making me think it is, I did get a lung, which is great. Definitely took that shoulder out. Let's trail him this way. Let's see if we can find our buck. Looking at that white material in the blood there, that is lung tissue. So shoulder incapacitated, lung hit. So this deer definitely crashed over there, did not get up. So lets me know I can go a little bit quicker over there to get it now. Temperatures will be rising here pretty soon. I don't want this deer sitting out here, you know, when it gets above 45 degrees. It's still in the 30s right now, so still see my breath. So you can look at this tissue. But We have a good trail. I don't have any fears whatsoever not finding this deer. Headed that way. Oh, there he is. Look at that buck. Look at that buck. Nice. Nice ridge buck. Whoa, yes. Man. Look at this guy. Whoa, yeah. What an amazing hunt. That was so exciting. We harvest this nice, mature 8-point. He's not a really old deer, but definitely backstrap's gonna taste sweet. 8-point, typical 8-point. His brow tines have these, I call them acorns on them. They're knobs. I see a lot of that out here on the ridge. It's just part of the genetics here. What a fun deer season it's been so far. You saw our bow season videos, and then of course today's video, we had that doe just meandering across the field. Let that one walk. I already harvested 2 doe this year. And then of course, those deer behind me in the tree stand that winded me, and then that one that came back later, and I used the grunt call to turn it around. That was so cool. I wish I had better video of it through the woods, but it was downwind of me, smelled me, and kept blowing, and then I'd use the grunt call, and it would turn around and come back, till eventually it went away. Then, of course, the 2 red fox coming out. One peed on that dog-proof trap, that predator trap. Oh my goodness, peed right on it. That was pretty funny. Those are red fox. I recently had a video where I had 2 gray fox running together. And that was a beautiful video, but these were 2 red fox right at dark there. And of course, getting out today with this big bruiser here. So excited. Probably gonna get a Euro mount made out of him. It's gonna be beautiful there on the in the Ridge office there in the farmhouse. So blessed to be able to get this. I hope you enjoyed today's hunting video. Trailing the deer through the woods, the blood trail, that was really cool. If you liked today's video, smash that thumbs up if you don't mind. Hit the notification bell to be notified anytime a new video comes out on RidgeLife. And if you haven't subscribed to RidgeLife, take time to do so now. I'd sure appreciate it. just got done hanging the deer up. If you look off in the distance there, there's a doe right there staring at me. Do y'all see it right there? Right there in that walk, in that pathway. See its ears twitching? Once again, such a blessing to have been able to harvest this deer. Thank you, Lord in heaven, for all the blessings throughout this past year. Hope everyone had a happy Thanksgiving. Hope you have a Merry Christmas. And from all of us here at RidgeLife, have a blessed day. Go RidgeLife.